Welcome, everyone, to WWF Prime Time. I'm Vince McMahon, along with Hillbilly Jim, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Bobby the Brain Heenan, Mr. Perfect, and yes, there were rumors just yesterday that the Ultimate Warrior would not be at Survivor Series. He would not team up with the Macho Man Randy Savage, and unfortunately, we can confirm that that is correct. The Macho Man Randy Savage must now choose a new tag team partner for the Survivor Series here at the 11th hour. With that in mind, we bring to you now, from Sarasota, Florida, courtesy of our studios in WJZY, here is the Macho Man Randy Savage. Macho Man Randy Savage, Jack Tunney, president of the WWF, has given you 24 hours to select a tag team partner here at the 11th hour. Unquestionably, there's a big payday for whomever it is you select. Nonetheless, I think you're going to have to be very, very choosy as to whom you select.
Can't be too choosy.
When you got 24 hours.
I heard that right there. World's been spinning around, Bobby Heenan. You've been in a wind tunnel, but I'm no stranger to the rain. Not even blinking because I got a name I'd like to, on the table right there on Prime Time. Yeah, and this is a word that's not synonymous with the name that I'm going to give you, and that's trust. Dig it? I'm talking about effective.
Well, excuse me one moment, but sure, Randy Savage, you've given us a great deal of thought, and Bobby Heenan, I know you and Mr. Perfect have also, since hearing the news, have given this a great deal of consideration.
Why don't you call Barbara Bush to see if George can come out and play? He doesn't have a job.
You're a real comedian right there, brother, but this is the Survivor Series. You understand that? We're talking about survival.
Yeah, but how are you going to put anything together with anybody in 24 hours? I mean, how are you going to have any tag team work done?
At some time in your life, you got to take a chance, and I've been one to do that on occasions. Yeah, not everything in life is just right down that four-lane highway, you dig? So I've got a guy, I'd like to find out if he's got the guts to be my tag team partner. Possibly he doesn't.
Well, now, who would you select? I mean, obviously someone who I would think would complement your style.
Well, bottom line, I don't know if he compliments it or not, because I personally don't even like the guy. I want to make that crystal clear. In fact,
he's going to pick somebody he don't like to be his partner.
You trust your instincts.
Would you please? Let's listen to the man, all right?
Like I say, sometimes you got to take a chance. Right. And this is a gut check for this guy, because I've never even wrestled him. He doesn't know if he can beat me or I can beat him.
Does he know you? Does he know your opponents?
Does he know my opponents?
Well, is he bigger than a bread box?
Come on, that was really cute. Let me tell you something that's even cuter. He knows my opponents way better than I do, and that's an advantage right there. Yeah. Does that sink in, Bobby the Brain? You're supposed to be so intelligent.
Yeah. Why don't you loosen your hat? You're not making any sense to me, pal.
All right,
Randy Savage, yes,
I make dollars and cents for my tag team partner if he wants to accept. Go ahead, Vince McMahon. What do you want to
ask? Just whom have you selected?
All right, you ready for this?
Yeah.
Big gut check, yeah. Mm-hmm. Possibly this guy could be the perfect tag team partner for me to go against Razor Ramon and Ric Flair. A bunch of intelligent Confuciuses around the table there.
Who do you mean the
perfect? Read between the lines.
Oh, man.
Do you mean that perfect tag team? Do you mean Randy Savage, who do you mean? Spell it out. Come on.
Spell it out. It's Mr. Perfect. You, brother. I'm pointing at you right
now. Perfect.
I don't know.
Hey, get the smile off your face, brother. Get the smile off your face. I'm serious.
You do make sense, Savage. I'll tell you why you make sense. This man knows more about Ric Flair personally. He knows more about him in the ring. He knows everything there is about
Ric
Flair.
See, Mr. Perfect, he can't even talk right now because he's nervous, because he knows that you could do the thing.
Well, he's guided him to the championship twice. Hey, of course you'd want him.
Mr. Perfect, they've been holding you back. You were... Hey, listen, I admired your wrestling ability, even though I don't like you. I think that you were one of the greatest in the World Wrestling Federation that ever was. Did you hear me? I'm complimenting you.
Macho, think about what you're saying, brother. Think about it.
I thought about it for 24 hours, night and day. Yeah. That's okay. You can refuse me right now. And then it makes me look a little bit bad. That's okay. That's cool, because surviving is the key right here. If you haven't got what it takes, Mr. Perfect, just tell the whole zillions of people all around the world that you can't handle what I'm
Well, nonetheless, Macho Man, I admire your choice, and you said
and
before...
And he knows he's under contract.
You'd have to take a chance, but... Yeah,
well, I'm not an attorney.
Hey, no, it makes sense to me that if anyone knew Ric Flair better than he does, it's got to be Mr. Perfect.
That's what he said.
He hasn't wrestled. He's a manager.
Yeah, no more.
He hasn't been in the ring in a long time,
Wouldn't
Macho.
You select Think Mr. Perfect? That. Oh, of course I would. I mean, who knows Ric Flair better? That's the natural thing to select.
Gut check,
but you've only got 24 hours. Strike one against you, pal.
Was that
now,
right?
Give me
Mr.
the next
Perfect,
choice.
You tell me. Is that strike one?
How about getting the little midget that yells, the plane, boss? Same thing.
Well, in any event, right now, let's take you to tag team action. We will follow the story as we proceed here on Prime Time. Let's take you to tag team action with high energy squaring off against the Beverly Brothers.
Max
continues his winning ways here in the WWF, and during these last several matches and the breaks, we've had a pretty interesting discussion about Macho Man's proposal. It seems to me that... He might be making a...
Out of the frying pan into the fire.
A little bit of
like.
Sense. I don't
Why
know.
Why don't you make it a six-man tag, and I'll team up with Perfect, and he can have two managers as his partner.
Well, he does have the right idea that nobody knows Flair like
Hello.
Perfect.
I'm a wrestler.
Yeah. Be calling here.
Long distance, excuse me, please, for Mr. Perfect.
Say hello to Rick for me.
Hello.
Are you crazy? Well, I'm very flattered.
By the way, we will have Ric Flair and Razor Ramon.
Come right here now, wait a minute.
We're here with us a little bit later on.
Tell me.
Be interesting to see what they have to say.
Absolutely, no question of that.
Tom Savage has less than 24 hours.
Wait, Tom Savage got less than 24 hours. Tell me. You liked it.
Uh-huh. Well, standing by right now, since our illustrious colleagues are busy on the phone, let's take you now to...
Well,
Sean
impressive.
Mooney in the event section.
Well, thank you very much. And Mr. Perfect has been making a call or receiving
a call.
I'm
certainly impressed, and I'll think about it. All right.
All the way throughout this event center, Sean. And I must say, you know, we were discussing this before.
I'll call him later.
Isn't this making a little sense to you guys or not?
Starting to fall together a little bit because nobody knows Flair or Ramon is probably as well as Perfect.
Only downside is that he ain't been in the ring in a while, and I'm worried about that with the Macho Man.
Well, wait a minute, though. It just seems to me that I know that you probably aren't giving us any serious consideration, but you might want to think about the fact, Mr. Perfect, that from the way I see it, and we were discussing before, it seems that Bobby Heenan has done a masterful job of, well, keeping you on the sideline, if you know what I mean. I mean,
Hold
here you've got Razor Ramon, you know. You've got Ric Flair. Two of the great superstars in the WWF. Does it make a little sense to you guys that Bobby would not want Mr. Perfect competing with those two?
That's true.
Well, does it make a little sense?
I mean,
Ric Flair's a glory hound. Give me a break.
Well, he does have an ego. Yes, I'll give you that. And Razor Ramon is one big, big, good-looking movie star-like dude.
So
you have to give him credit for that.
You're trying to keep Mr. Perfect out of the
box. Wouldn't it make some sense, though? I'm not saying you are, but wouldn't it make some sense that you would do that?
Wouldn't you would do that?
Pal. Do what? Keep you out of action? You're a great broadcaster. You're on prime time with me.
Yes.
Then you also do Superstars with McMahon.
And I'm still the greatest wrestler.
Well, of course you're the greatest wrestler. You're perfect. We know that.
But why is he not wrestling then?
Because he's a manager. He's just he's not just a manager. He's an executive consultant. You wouldn't even know that. There is no consultant for you, if you dumb hick. But this man, he's the one that guided Ric Flair to the top. He's the one that's walked him through
You know, right in front of this man, you're saying that this is the second time you've said he's the man who guided Ric Flair.
Right.
Bobby Heenan, that is bull compared to what you normally say. You take the credit.
Your public
have stated before
that
it was you who guided Ric Flair,
right.
And Perfect had nothing to do with it.
No, I was.
You said that.
Did
you say that?
No. I was the one that said I selected you. I mentioned your name when I was managing you. And you were Intercontinental Champion. Then when Flair came into the WWE, I told him, here's the guy you got to have. Here's the guy you got to have, Mr. Perfect.
Here's the guy that could compete with you, Ric Flair. Therefore, let's make a deal.
No.
Pay him off, probably, and have him as an executive consultant. Give him a big fancy name,
just
right?
Just the manager is what you called him. Just the manager is what you called him.
He is a manager.
Just the manager?
Yeah, well, you're not just a manager.
We'll be back at WWE Prime Time. Vince McMahon here along with Hacksaw Jim, Duggan Hillbilly Jim, Mr. Perfect, Bobby the Brain Heenan, and You know, we were talking, this is seeming to, as outlandish as the original proposal from the Macho Man seemed, this is starting to make a little
sense
to you.
Starting to fit together, like the pieces of the puzzle starting to come together. At first, it sounded like a wild idea, but now you look, step back and take a look at it.
Yeah.
I know what Savage is doing. Savage is trying to throw us off track. He's got his partner selected already, probably signed, sealed, and delivered. He wants to say that it's going to be perfect, knowing perfect hasn't been in the ring in over a year, and on a...
Just cause a little dissension amongst you
guys. Yeah, that's what he wants
There's
to do.
There's been dissension amongst you guys for a while.
Oh, there is.
Maybe he wants to survive, and that's the best way to survive with that man right there. Well, you ever thought about that?
Yeah, but you come up with somebody better than picking perfect, though. I mean, if you're going to try to stump us and make a fool out of
us. Shot?
Well, I don't know about that, but standing by right now, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you, courtesy of our studio's brother in Charlotte, North Carolina. Standing by, Ric Flair, Razor Ramon.
Hello.
WWFB presenting these two gentlemen. You've been perhaps listening on to this broadcast thus far, and your reaction to the Macho Man Randy Savage naming Mr. Perfect as potentially his tag team partner at Survivor Series.
Okay, McMahon, we heard what Savage said. Hey, Perfect, forget about him, man. He loco. You work for us, man. You had a great reputation, man. I understand he used to be somebody, huh, Ric? But now you work for us, man. We pay you good, you do what we tell you, right, man?
You know, it makes for great copy. Some people will go at no length to create an entertainment environment. Hillbilly Jim, Jim Duggan McMahon, the reason you guys are behind the table is because you find things like this humorous. The greatest unit in wrestling today is Perfect and Flair. I do the wrestling, he does the consulting. That's why we are success personified. Right, Bobby?
You're right, Ric. And I didn't get a chance to talk to you a minute ago when you called, but I want to talk to you after the program. I got something very important to tell you.
That wasn't me that called.
What? Well, the Macho Man Randy Savage is going to make a call, and I disagree with you. I don't think he's bluffing. I don't think he's making this up. And gentlemen,
who was on the phone?
I think you should take very seriously this consideration, and I think Mr. Perfect should take very seriously this consideration. I mean, Mr. Flair, it has been suggested that Mr. Perfect, either you have been living in his shadow or he's been living in your shadow, and I don't know how you feel about that, but it has been said before.
Why don't you keep trying to stir it up? We walked down that aisle together, me in front, him behind me. That's the way the unit goes. That's the way we coexist. I'm the wrestler. No question. Ask him, who's the greatest wrestler alive today, Perfect? Let's clarify this right now. Get it on the table. Savage, if you're listening, let's get this over with. We got to prepare for Survivor Series. We don't need any more from Savage. He's run out of time, and he's run out of hopes.
So Ric Flair, hold on. This is Hillbilly Jim here. Are you saying, if I'm not mistaken, that Mr. Perfect is just the manager? That's all he can do anymore?
I'm saying that he works for me.
He's a great manager, man. He's a great manager.
He's
with us, man. He wanted the bad guys.
He's
with us.
Perfect, say something. You ain't saying nothing. What do you got to say about this? Are you just a manager? Are you not a great wrestler anymore?
What's wrong with you, Hillbilly Jim?
Well, I'm asking you a question.
That's a good question. Is Ric Flair, in your estimation, a better wrestler than you? Just answer the question yes or no.
No.
All right, okay, fine. Mr. Flair, you heard that.
God.
Raise your mind right now.
This is getting
out of
hand.
What you thinking about?
We're not getting out of hand, man. I can see what you're trying to do. I know what Savage is trying to do. He's going to, whoever his partner is going to be, he wants us all to be at each other's throats. It's not going to work. I handle the money. You go down the aisle behind him. Flair and Ramon, you get in the ring and do a number on him.
That's behind. Always in the shadow. Always on following the in the footsteps. Come on,
okay,
what
you can walk in front. What's the big deal? Damn.
Perfect.
Nothing that important. Who walks in front or back?
Perfect. Clarify it for him. Come on.
Tell him, man.
Come on, clarify. Let's get on with business. We got things to do.
Are you a better wrestler, Mr. Perfect, in your estimation, than Razor Ramon?
No way.
Yes or no?
No way.
Well, he's got pride in himself. Nothing wrong with that.
I'm the greatest wrestler in the World Wrestling Federation, period.
You're perfect. It seems as though we have a difference of opinion with that in mind. Yes, Mr. Ramon.
I understand you used to be somebody, man. You got a great rep,
stop
man.
It.
On the street, you got
what
a great
you
reputation.
Used to be somebody.
But you're all through, man. You
all
an
through.
Announcer, man. You a manager, man.
What do you mean to used to be? What do you mean all
you
through?
You work for us, man.
Let's go to something.
He said he was a has-been.
Executive action now involving a relative newcomer in the WWF, Lance Cassidy. We will continue to follow this story. Stay
just
with him under contract.
A whole lot better idea, you know?
Yeah.
Welcome back to more WWF Prime Time. Continuing our discussion here in the proposal by the Macho Man Randy Savage. And you know, when you think about it, what an unbelievable opportunity this will be for someone. Because, I mean, you're talking about a tremendous payday here.
Exactly.
And an opportunity right back, right on top, right in the limelight. And I've got to think, Mr. Perfect, that I've got to think you're seriously considering this because, I mean, monetarily, you are a professional, are you not?
I'm definitely a professional.
You consider yourself to be the greatest wrestler of all time, I would suggest.
I don't think there's any doubt in anybody's mind about that.
I see. But surely there isn't. You're...
No, there isn't.
Oh, but Ric Flair just said he was the greatest wrestler of all time.
Well, he's got pride in himself. He's got pride in himself. So what? Ric Flair is an active wrestler. Two times WWF champion.
Would you blame anyone for seizing this opportunity? Forget about Mr. Perfect right now. Hypothetically. I mean, you're talking about a tremendous payday.
Right.
And after all, we are professionals, right?
Right.
So you can't blame Mr. Perfect if he chose to come into the ring and team up with the Macho Man Randy Savage for this one. You can't blame
him for something
that.
You don't know about. That's called loyalty in the heart. They could offer you $20 million a day. He's not going no place.
How about respect? You're not giving this man the respect that's due him. You're saying he's just a manager. Razor Ramon said he was a half-man.
And living in the shadow of Ric Flair?
That's
walking
right.
in the
shadow? No, I mean he's not walking. He's got his own shadow.
Do you understand?
I walk in no man's shadow, first of all.
You're right.
Okay.
You're right.
Let's set that up.
I didn't say you did.
Well, we understand.
Don't you see what they're doing to us?
Like the
only reason we work is because
here.
We all have our jobs. Flair gets in the ring and does his. You do all the consulting. I handle the money. We all have to take orders. Don't you understand that?
Yeah, but I don't plan taking orders and keeping this man on the shelf, keeping
right.
him out of competition,
right.
knowing that he's going to compete with Ramon, knowing that he's going to compete with Ric Flair.
Right.
Come on, Bobby Heenan. You know what you've been doing to this
I
man.
I haven't been doing anything to him.
You certainly
you
have.
You think I want him to get in that ring and get killed?
Hey, look at all the paydays he would not
well,
get.
I mean.
Well, you mean you don't think he's competent?
Well, he hasn't been
ring?
In the ring in how long? He's a great athlete. He's perfect. But you can't get in the ring.
You're saying he was a great athlete.
No,
he
is. You is a great athlete.
I mean, Arby. Is that what you're saying?
No.
Arby.
What are you saying?
Arby, we're not talking about sandwiches.
No.
We're talking about Mr. Perfect.
No, wait a minute. Stop. Give me some water. What I want to get to is the man. Is a perfect.
Well, he's not going to pass up an opportunity like this if he's perfect.
There's no reason for him to get in the ring. Do you understand this?
Why is it
getting
in the ring? He can make a lot more money.
I can give you whatever you want. You don't have to get in that ring. Let me just ask you this.
All right, let's get to the bottom.
God!
Mr. Perfect, are you afraid? Are you afraid
are you
of Ric Flair?
Are you
afraid of Razor Ramon? Are you afraid of the Macho Man Randy Savage? Are you afraid of this opportunity?
I'm not afraid of any man. And as far as it goes for Bobby saying, I haven't been in the ring in so long, that doesn't mean that I can't walk in that ring tomorrow and perform perfectly.
He said you was a has-been.
I did not. You're the property
owner.
That? No.
No.
Did you say that?
I give you my word.
Just remember.
The big boss man squaring up against the model.
You shut
Rick Martel. Razor Ramon continues his winning ways here in the World Wrestling Federation. Razor Ramon, par excellence in terms of his skills in the squared circle. And, of course, the Razor at the Survivor Series is teaming up with Ric Flair, squaring off against the Macho Man Randy Savage and, well, we don't know. But speaking of the Macho Man Randy Savage, let's take you back to Sarasota, Florida. All right, Macho Man, your assessment of what has transpired thus far tonight on Primetime.
I'm in a state of confusion right now because I don't know if I made the right decision or the wrong decision to throw it on the lap of Mr. Perfect like that. Maybe the pressure, I don't even know. But, you know, Bobby the Brain Heenan and the ruthless Razor Ramon. Maybe Razor Ramon kind of scares Mr. Perfect. I don't know. And maybe it's a little bit cold in the shadow of Ric Flair, Mr. Perfect. Ooh. Is that true or not? I don't know. I gave you a chance to get into the spotlight with the Macho Man Randy Savage, but perhaps Perhaps all the above is true, but perhaps also Bobby the Brain Heenan's got you under his thumb, so to speak. I don't know. You know what I mean? This is something you got to ask yourself. Look in the mirror, Mr. Perfect. What do you see? You know what I think I see? I think I see that you are a little bit afraid of the whole situation, yeah. And maybe you haven't got the guts to be the Macho Man's tag team partner in the Survivor Series.
Savage, you shut up right there. First of all, I've never cared for you in the first place. And second of all, Razor Ramon or Ric Flair, I'm not afraid of either one. In fact, I could wrestle all three of you guys in one night by myself.
I like that attitude, except for one thing. You know, I don't like you either, you know, but that was the attitude that I was hoping for. But I still don't think you have what it takes to be my tag team partner in the Survivor Series. Now, listen to me right now. If you want to give it consideration, please do. You know what I mean? Just, keep it there, and if you've got the guts, then accept the challenge.
What about it? Come on, Mr. Perfect. Do you have the guts or not? Are you going to consider this proposal?
It's time now.
Are you going to consider it?
I'll consider it.
You hear him? You're a what?
I'll consider it.
Consider? No, you're not going to consider anything.
Well, tell me what I'm going to consider or I'm not going to consider.
You're not going to sit down for a minute. You're not going
to tell me to sit down either.
You're not going to consider anything. There's nothing to consider.
All I'm going to do is consider it. There's a lot of money at stake.
I got money. You're
not afraid of any man.
You're
not afraid of anybody.
Going to consider nothing. There's nothing to consider.
We're back with more WWF Prime Time. And Mr. Perfect is indeed taking into consideration the proposal by the Macho Man Randy Savage. With that in mind, let's take you back to Sarasota and Charlotte, respectively. Macho Man Randy Savage, along with Ric Flair, Razor Ramon. And gentlemen, you and Charlotte can't be happy about any of this whatsoever.
You're perfect. Oyame, chico. Calmase y cállate. Calm down and shut up. You listen to Bobby Heenan, you listen to Razor Ramon, you listen to Ric Flair. You work for us, Chico. You're one of the bad guys. And one more thing, man. You say you could beat all three of us in one night, man?
Razor, no.
You've been sitting on your soft behind a microphone for over 1 year. You haven't wrestled three men in 1 year, Chico. Remember where you come from, man. Ric Flair, Bobby Heenan made you somebody.
Razor, I told you, when you travel with me.
No, listen. You listen to me right
sometimes
now. Mr. Perfect.
Wait a minute. Hold on. Perfect. Kid, explain to him.
Listen.
This is a bad joke.
Listen.
Let's clarify it right now. Savage, McMahon, Hillbilly Jim, Duggan, turn around. Look at Perfect. He's my baby. He's my baby. I brought him along. Perfect. Clarify it.
Listen.
Tell him where you're at. Lear jets, limousines, jet flying, kiss stealing. You are one of the boys now.
Come with us.
One of my boys. And there's nothing wrong with walking in the shadow of Ric Flair. A lot of people walk in the shadow of John Wayne.
There you go, Mr. Perfect. They say you can't do it. I say that you can. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you can't. Razor Ramon tells you to shut up. You don't say nothing. Whoa. This guy, Ric Flair, says he wants you to ride in his limousine and be his baby. Yeah.
He is
that
my
what you
baby.
Are? Are you a baby? Where's your guts,
Savage.
Perfect? Whoa. Do you
Look
have the guts?
The
do you have
this
the guts?
This isn't a game anymore. It's a
do you
team.
Want to be under Heenan's thumb? Perfect for one time
Perfect.
In your life. Don't
Perfect.
Be Flair's
Get
baby.
At yourself. Come on.
Perfect.
Tell him.
Be a man for one time in your life.
Harden up, Chico.
Are you a man or are you a baby?
Come on, Perfect.
Got the guts or you don't have the guts. I can't go to the ring with consideration. I need a commitment from a man.
Perfect. Get out of that chair and get on a phone right now.
Come
on.
Mr. Perfect.
It's not too late. Come on.
You know where I'm at.
My offer still stands.
It's not too late. Come on.
But I need an answer from you. I had 24 hours
Perfect.
To make my decision.
Perfect.
I didn't have any trouble.
Can
I picked you because
perfect.
I think you're great.
It's me.
And I think
Razor.
You're perfect.
You're the kid.
But maybe I'm wrong. You got less than 30 minutes. You got to give me a bottom line answer, and then I'll go listen. I'll go look for somebody else.
All right, Mr.
Takes
Perfect,
the challenge.
Spot. Let's take you,
got
you to more
guts.
WWF
well, then
action.
Tell me.
Well, I can tell you the tension continuing to build to a fever pitch. Please, 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 gentlemen. It is time, Mr. Perfect, for you to put up or shut up.
That's right.
Will you be the tag team?
How do you like that? How do you like that? How do you like that, Heenan? How do you like that, you weasel?
We're back with our WWF Prime Time without a wet weasel who no doubt is drying off, but no doubt Razor Ramon and Ric Flair could very well be all wet in the Survivor Series. It is going to happen. The Macho Man Randy Savage teams up with Mr. Perfect. Let's take you back to Sarasota. Man. Randy Savage, you got to be ecstatic.
I got chills up and down my spine. Mr. Perfect, I know you're not a baby. Yeah, I knew it all along. You are a man. I knew you'd stand up and get out of that channel and get in the spotlight with the Macho Man Randy Savage. I like your style. I don't like you. That stands. And I know you don't like me, but we respect each other as athletes. And I knew you'd be the most effective partner that I could get for the Survivor Series. I put the ball in your lap and you ran with it. Yeah, you scored a touchdown. Congratulations, and let's do it at the Survivor Series. Thumbs up.
Charlotte, North Carolina. Are you there, Ric Flair?
Yo, perfecto. Oyeme, chico. Estupido. What are you thinking about, man? You double-cross Razor Ramon and Ric Flair, man? Yeah. That happened to Razor before, man, one time. Only he's not here to talk about it.
You had it all. You had life at your fingertips. Wine, women, song, Learjets, limousines a mile long, a lifestyle that kings live to have. You had me guiding you through life. I gave you everything. I gave you life after wrestling. You were somebody. And now you think, buy a ticket now. As you sit there with that cocky smear on your face.
Look at him. Look at that little
note. Think about this. Wednesday night, it won't be throwing the pencil in the air. Wednesday night, it'll be good, and you know what it'll be.
Your body
is a mile long, disguised as a hearse, because Henning, that's your real name. Henning, it's not perfect anymore.
No, man.
And Savage will have to survive.
Survive.
Come on.
I want to see whose career's not going to survive the Survivor Series. That's you, Razor Ramon, and that's you, Ric Flair. Flair, you've wanted to be like me for a long time. Well, too bad. It's too bad. And you, Razor Ramon, give me a break.
Yeah. I'm going to give you a break, man. A fucking nut, you punk.
You put Macho Man Randy Savage and you put Mr. Perfect in the ring at the same time. You know what you got?
Not much.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You know what you got? You got the perfect team.
Prove it, Chico. Prove it.
You live with that.
Prove it Wednesday.
And after Survivor Series is all over with, and Macho Man Randy Savage and Mr. Perfect are standing in the middle of the ring with our hands held high in victory, a sign of perfection.
Yeah.
Ric Flair, the last thing you're going to hear from Mr. Perfect, when you're laying down, when you're on your way out of that ring, I'm standing there with the Macho Man in victory, the last thing you hear will be, woo!
It's official, and this is the biggest news I can recall in recent World Wrestling Federation history. At the Survivor Series, this Wednesday night in the main event, the Ultimate Warrior is out. And the Macho Man Randy Savage has said if he had his druthers, there was only one man he would choose to be his partner. As a matter of fact, here's what the Macho Man had to say this past Monday night on WWF Prime Time Wrestling.
I mean, who knows Ric Flair better? That's the natural thing to select.
Little did Bobby Heenan know how prophetic he was at the time he made those comments. As a matter of fact, Randy Savage did make the perfect choice. And earlier this week, I had an opportunity to talk with the perfect team. Macho Man Randy Savage, I don't have to tell you that Ric Flair and Razor Ramon are absolutely livid with whom you've chosen to be your tag team partner this Wednesday night at the Survivor Series.
Well, that's too bad. You guys need to get over it, yeah, because that's the name of the game is surviving, and I am a survivor. That's why at the 11th hour, I reached out and picked the guy that I don't necessarily like, yeah, of all the wrestlers in the World Wrestling Federation, past, present, and future, that I could have picked for this one occasion and one occasion only. I think I picked the perfect tag team partner, Mr. Perfect, and together against Razor Ramon and Ric Flair, we're going to make him tired of living and scared of dying, yeah.
Who would ever thought this? Who would ever thought? You know, Savage, I don't especially care for you either, you know?
Hey, I don't like you either, What are you trying to say?
Hey, you and I never met each other inside the squared circle. Lucky for you.
No, lucky for you.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yeah?
Well, not so lucky for you, Ric Flair and Razor Ramon. We got ya! Here I am, standing right up next to the Macho Man, flying high. You know, Ric Flair, you were the one the whole time. You were walking in Mr. Perfect's footsteps. You are walking in Mr. Perfect's shadow. You wanted to be like Mr. Perfect. Well, too bad. There's only one Mr. Perfect, and that's me. And Razor Ramon, the favor I did for you, I'm the man who brought you into the World Wrestling Federation. And now I'm going to do myself a favor by eliminating you from the World Wrestling Federation. I'm standing up here next to the Macho Man Randy Savage. Unbelievable.
Like.
And Bobby Heenan trying to manipulate me this whole time, trying to keep me out of the ring because he wanted Ric Flair to have the spotlight. Well, Mr. Perfect is back, and Mr. Perfect and the Macho Man Randy Savage are going to take the spotlight, and Survivor Series, we are going to survive.
I like it. The confidence that he has and the attitude that he has. We're on the same wavelength, same frequency. Yeah.
Ric Flair. Woo!
Oh, yeah. Dig it.
Well, we're back with more WWF action. Bobby the Brain Heenan, and it appears as though Randy Savage has indeed chosen for this Wednesday night Survivor Series the perfect tag team partner.
Oh, yeah. He's got the perfect tag team partner, all right. How could Perfect do this to me? How could he do this to Ric Flair? How could he stab us in the back after all we did for him? The only reason he's famous and the only reason he's Mr. Perfect is because of me and Ric Flair. And then he turns around and stabs us in the back, bites the hand that fed him.
Hey, why don't you chill out for
this
a moment?
Contest is what's good.
From inside the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update. Update brought to you by Coliseum Home Video, the exclusive distributors of great World Wrestling Federation action cassettes. Supplies are limited. They're only $9.95 while they last. Available at fine video stores everywhere. Now then, if you thought that Ric Flair and Razor Ramon were upset with Mr. Perfect for joining forces with Macho Man Randy Savage before the Survivor Series, you haven't seen anything yet. Watch as our television cameras caught Flair and Ramon this past Wednesday night leaving the Richfield Coliseum after their match, blowing out the back door.
Go put the bed in.
Right. Oh, Mr. Flair, we're going to comment on the outcome of Survivor Series.
You want a comment? Okay, man, here's a comment for you. Here's one for you, Mr. Perfect.
Come on, Razor.
You double-cross Razor Ramon, man. I'm going to carve you up, Chico. I'm going to carve you up, man.
It ain't right.
Perfect, you're living and riding high on borrowed time. Remember that.
Let's go. Let's go, man. Go.
Max Moon is really rolling here in the WWF. Right now, let's take you to the update.
From inside the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update. Update brought to you by WWF Super WrestleMania. Available for the first time ever on Sega Genesis. Wow, take a look at this unbelievable action. What a great idea for holiday gift giving. And it's available now at fine stores everywhere. I'm here in this empty arena now, but in just a few hours, World Wrestling Federation champion Bret the Hitman Hart will once again be defending his title in front of thousands of enthusiastic fans. As you recall, Bret Hart had one chance against Ric Flair in Saskatoon, and he was able to capitalize on that opportunity. But if you think about it, it really began some years ago here at the World Wrestling Federation when Bret the Hitman Hart arrived on the scene. Initially, he became a World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion. Later, the Intercontinental Champion. And all the while, building a foundation for a career put together on technique, guts, determination, and most certainly perseverance. He has quite possibly put together the most ambitious schedule of title defenses in World Wrestling Federation history. Example, in just over 2 weeks, Bret Hart met and defeated the Berserker on Prime Time Wrestling. Then 5 days later, he defeated Papa Shango on Saturday night's main event. A week later, it was Virgil on WWF Superstars. And that was just 4 days before his spectacular title defense against the red-hot Shawn Michaels at the Survivor Series. You look up work ethic in the dictionary, and there's a picture of Bret the Hitman Hart. Undoubtedly the hardest working champion in World Wrestling Federation history. What an incredible schedule. A schedule that many say Bret Hart cannot maintain and remain the World Wrestling Federation champion. One of the individuals questioning Bret Hart is number one contender Ric Flair. And recently I caught up with the Nature Boy in a setting that's just as familiar to him as a wrestling ring. You know, Nature Boy, Ric Flair, you're obviously obsessed with becoming the World Wrestling Federation champion for yet a third time. To do so, you're going to have to go through current champion Bret the Hitman Hart. Now, it appears to me it's a little tough for you to stay focused on Bret Hart when you're always thinking of Mr. Perfect.
First of all, Gene, I'm obsessed with greatness. I'm obsessed with being number one. And to be number one, you have to be the World Wrestling Federation champion. That's cut and dried. As for Perfect, he's a man that travels the world emulating Ric Flair. He's a man that's trying to run from the shadow of the greatness, of the aura of Ric Flair. And I'll deal with Perfect on a different level when the time is right.
You know, I always got the impression that that relationship was a mutual admiration society. I think Mr. Perfect did as much good for you as you did for him. On to the subject of Bret Hart. Bret Hart is the man, is he not, who defeated you for the World Wrestling Federation title in Saskatoon. And he did it with a submission hold right in the middle of the ring. That devastating leg lock known as the sharpshooter. That brought you down.
You know, a lot of people would take personal offense to being leaned on by the press like you're leaning on me. Instead, I'm going to approach it from a different angle. There again, demonstrating my greatness in a different form. Bret Hart right now beat a man who stubbed his toe in Saskatoon, Canada. A nothing happening town in a nothing happening country. The great one showed that he's vulnerable. The great one stubbed his toe. And Bret Hart is the World Wrestling Federation champion. But what really makes Bret Hart ride so high in the sky right now is, Gene, he not only is the World Wrestling Federation champion, he beat Ric Flair to get there. That really makes you big time.
You know, I should also remind you that he is right now the World Wrestling Federation champion. You're not. These opportunities don't come along too often, even though I do know you're going to be meeting him in the very near future.
And last week I was sitting here with Cindy Crawford, and this week I'm not. What does that mean?
Hey, what is it?
Anything I want, life comes my way. It's cut and dried. Bret Hart, I'm on my way to a third championship. You, my friend, ride that lightning bolt called fleeting fame into the sky. It was great knowing you. It was great calling you champ. But, pal, your days are numbered. Here's to Ric Flair.
Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week, the World Wrestling Federation champion, Bret the Hitman.
All right, here he comes. Take a look at this, Bobby the Brain Heenan. A standing ovation for the World Wrestling Federation champion. It didn't appear. What do you mean? What's the matter with you?
Nothing. I'm just, to see him with that belt just upsets me.
As well it should, but I think you better get used to it.
Can't get used to it.
All right, Bret Hart, World Wrestling Federation champion. There are those who say you have an appointment with destiny. You might be making that two times. Number one, at the Royal Rumble, January 24th in Sacramento, you're going to be defending your title against Razor Ramon. However, during the interim, you're going to be facing Nature Boy Ric Flair, a man who says you are defending your title too much. As a result, he, as two-time World Wrestling Federation champion, will be champion for the third time in the World Wrestling Federation, and you would pay the price.
You know, Gene, there's a lot of people in the World Wrestling Federation that think I'm setting some kind of a crazy pace, that I'm gonna burn myself out as the World Wrestling Federation champion, but I'm not. Because it was one big accomplishment for me to be the World Wrestling Federation champion. But it goes a lot deeper than that. I want to be the greatest World Wrestling Federation champion of all time. And the only way to do that is to take on all challenges. And
I know Ric Flair,
you're not going anywhere.
Bobby the Brain Heenan, where are you going?
Go ahead, Bobby, come back here.
Neck.
That man needs to be taught some respect.
I'm not worried about Ric Flair. Never have been, and I'm never gonna be. And Razor Ramon doesn't scare me one single bit.
Whoa. What are you doing here?
I am a broadcast journalist. I can go any place I want. But I want to talk to you, champ. First of all, at Royal Rumble, you are wrestling Razor Ramon, correct?
Oh yeah, you're right.
What makes you think by the time Royal Rumble takes place, you'll even be packing this gold, champ? Because you're going to be meeting Ric Flair along the way. And should by some fluke you get by Ric Flair, you will never survive the match with Razor Ramon at the Royal Rumble.
You think so? You think Ric Flair intimidates me? He gave up to the sharpshooter, and as far as Razor Ramon goes, Mr. Machismo, he doesn't have the technical ability to beat the excellence of execution in the Royal Rumble.
I was talking. See, if you don't understand something, if the right one don't get you, then the left one will. And at this time, let me introduce the right one.
Listen up. This is a long story. It's a short story. And how you won that and where you won that means nothing. Because I'll guarantee you this, oh illustrious Hitman, there is an arena in the world right now that has this ready to pop up on the marquee. It says Ric Flair. World Wrestling Federation champion for the third time.
Nice to dream, isn't it?
In closing, some little girl one night told me that you dared to imply that you were the man. That to be the man, you had to beat the man. Well, I got a new one for you. Being the man and staying the man are two different things, Mr. Hart.
No doubt about it. And now, champ, let me introduce you to the left one.
Oh,
the man who is oozing machismo, my good friend, Razor Ramon.
What is going on? Disrupting the interview with the Hitman, Bret Hart.
Oh, Bobby never ceases to amaze me. He's always got something up his sleeve. This is great.
The Hitman, Bret Hart, obviously outnumbered in this situation. And the Hitman taking off his jacket. He's going to be ready.
Here, Razor. Hitman.
Huh. You're the excellence
of execution, Chico. Razor Ramon, he know all about execution. I already proved I'm the only man in the WWF who is oozing machismo. And Hitman, everybody knows that Razor Ramon is the only man in the WWF who looks good in gold. And after the Royal Rumble, I'm going to have your gold around my waist.
Mistake.
Ric Flair from behind. Flair and Razor Ramon double teaming the WWF champion.
This is great. That's what he deserves. You know it.
Wait a minute. Mr. Perfect, where did he come from? Perfect and Razor Ramon hammering it out. Bret Hart and Ric Flair going at it. What is going on?
Where did he come from? What's he doing sticking his nose in something that's not his business?
Bobby the Brain Heenan interrupting the interview with a hitman. Bret Hart shimming Flair and Ramon out to double team. Bret Hart.
And Perfect just got put in their place, don't you think?
Look at this! They're gonna get some more. Here comes Flair! Here comes the Razor! Flair and Ramon mean business. There's no question about it. Both men desperately want to be the World Wrestling Federation champion. Mr. Perfect.
I see fear in that face.
Standing next to the World Wrestling Federation champion. That's what it's all about. The Hitman, Bret Hart.
All right, Bret Hart, to what depths will Ric Flair and Razor Ramon stoop to take the WWF title away from you?
They'll stoop to any level. Ric Flair and Razor Ramon, you tried to jump me like a pack of wild jackals, but it's not going to make any difference. Ric Flair, you've already made one mistake. You underestimated me once before. And Razor Ramon, Mr. Machismo, you gotta have some kind of wrestling background to beat the excellence of execution. I don't care if it's one of you or both of you, but both of you are gonna pay because I want you bad.
I'm a big fan of Mr. Perfect, but I've got to admit, every time that Ric Flair and Razor Ramon turn around, there's Mr. Perfect in their face. I can hardly wait to hear what Flair and Ramon have to say about their current state of affairs.
You think this is over, Hart? You think you've heard the last of us? You're not going to be able to walk anywhere in the face of this earth without no owner right behind you, around the next corner. It's going to be the Razor and an HMR. And next time, and he won't be there to protect you. One of us is taking that belt.
Yo, Hitman, if there's anything left, when Slick Rick gets through, the Razor will carve you.
The rally was gone, taking Ric Flair back.
And that may do it. Two and two.
He's up.
No. Mr. Perfect barely getting that right shoulder up off the mat. Berserker persistent as ever. A whip to the ropes, off in the back. No.
Wait a minute.
There's the Perfect.
Unbelievable.
The Perfect punching.
I like it. There it is.
Yeah, he did, but his big ego will be his downfall. Look at him. He thinks he's great.
Look at the replay right here. Right in the midst of adversity, Mr. Perfect hooks the
just said, Big Ego, I understand that this guy has a custom-made telephone. It doesn't ring, it applauds.
Ooh. Well, it could be applauding at the Royal Rumble.
Yeah, you bet. It's perfect. To the update we go.
From inside the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update. Update brought to you by IcoPro, the integrated conditioning programs. IcoPro takes this opportunity to wish you a happy, healthy 1993. You know, over the years, we've all become accustomed to Bobby Heenan's rhetoric. Some of it totally useless. On the other hand, some of that rhetoric with great merit. Right now, let's hear from the man known as the Brain.
You know something, Mr. Perfect. You got a pretty high opinion of yourself. You think you are the perfect athlete? The perfect wrestler? Well, after Ric Flair gets finished with you, you are going to be flawed, scarred, and tarnished. Which is why I will unveil to you, Mr. Perfect, and to all the humanoids throughout the world at the Royal Rumble, someone who is beyond perfect. Someone who not only has a high opinion of himself, but is justifiably truly in love with himself. And then, Mr. Perfect, when you feast your eyes on the person that I will unveil at the Royal Rumble, you will look back and say, "Why, I wasn't perfect at all. I didn't really measure up. I was really nothing without the influence of Bobby the Brain. If only I could look like Narcissus." That's right. All you ham and eggers at the Royal Rumble, the drape will drop. And so will the mouths of every man, woman, and child when you feast your eyes on Narcissus.
While listening to those comments from Bobby the Brain Heenan, I asked our producer for the dictionary. And here's what Noah Webster has to say about the definition of narcissus. A conceited, self-centered person. Thinking too highly of oneself. And unduly preoccupied with one's own appearance. Well, if this individual is everything that Bobby the Brain Heenan says he is, then I, for one, cannot wait till the Royal Rumble to see Narcissus. As we say here on the World Wrestling Federation, folks, stay tuned. With Update, I'm Gene Okerlund.
Talking about the Royal Rumble, you gotta be talking about the nature boy, Ric Flair. Last year, over in New York, at the Royal Rumble, I beat 29 of the greatest WWF superstars all in one night. It lasted an hour and 10 minutes. It was the nature boy that won it all. So this year, the Royal Rumble, all the big stars of the WWF, and Mr. Perfect, I'll be coming for you.
This is all. El Matador, knee left.
Competition is unbelievable.
Off the rope, and yes, he nails him. Cover that man. Santana should have covered Flair right there. Off the rope for another. Oh, look at that.
That wasn't an offensive maneuver on the part of Flair. It was all defense. He just fell right down. Wait a minute. What's this?
Uh-oh.
Monday Night Raw, West Side Story.
I don't know. My goodness, maybe we can get a camera back there. Perhaps we can get a camera back there. I don't know, but wow, did they ever go at it. Oh, my goodness.
That's the way it's done, just like that.
Let's take you now, ladies and gentlemen, this commercial break. We'll be right back with a word with Ric Flair and perhaps even Mr. Perfect when we return. Stay with us. Oh, my goodness.
We're live here on Monday Night Raw.
Get a word with
the Manhattan Center.
Ric Flair. If he can. Oh, no.
I don't think we're going to get a word at all.
No.
Big fight going on, Bartlett.
It's still going on.
Perfect wants Flair, no doubt about it. He's saying, come on, but he's not going toward Perfect. He doesn't.
You don't talk to me. The rules go. The WWF isn't big enough for me and Mr. Perfect. So right here, live in front of God and the whole world, here next week, I want Perfect!
All right, that's pretty clear. You can't get any clearer than that. Ric Flair will look out.
One of us stays, one of us goes. Not out of the building, but out of the WWF.
I can't believe you would risk your career, Mr. Flair. I can't believe you would do that. And I'm not too sure that Mr. Perfect is going to do that either. I can't believe, and you started.
I can tell you right now, you're not mad enough. You haven't got the guts, and you will never see the day in your life you beat Ric Flair.
Take a Prozac.
Yes, that's pretty clear. Ric Flair issuing a challenge to Mr. Perfect. Hopefully before we go off the air, we will have a retort of some sort, perhaps an answer from Mr. Perfect. Guys, I don't know what to say. We're rocking and rolling here.
Sounds like the end of the road for somebody, guaranteed. Here he comes. There's my guy right there, Mr. Perfect.
Well, I guess we didn't have to wait. I don't know if you heard that challenge or not from Ric Flair. He states the WWF is not big enough for the two of you. He's going to put his career in the WWF on the line if you will.
You're talking about meeting Ric Flair and the loser has to leave the World Wrestling Federation?
Here, right here next week.
Are you kidding me? I'll take that in a heartbeat. Ric Flair, you're going to be gone. McMahon, you know me. Everybody knows me. I am what I say I am, Flair. You want me? You got me right here.
I must say, I can't imagine you putting your career on the line like that, or even Ric Flair. It's going too far. Both of you are great competitors. Why risk that?
Is that what it has to take? Ric Flair, is that what it's gone down to? The two greatest athletes in the World Wrestling Federation? Only one man will stay in the World Wrestling Federation. I'll take that challenge. I'll put my career on the line right here.
Thank you very much. It can't be any clearer than
Mr. Perfect.
Mr. Perfect puts his career on the line next week, one-on-one with Ric Flair. And of course, the Macho Man Randy Savage meeting the Repo Man. One-on-one as well. And maybe the Macho Man can find his hat.
It's going to be World War III next Monday night.
We're back with more Monday Night Raw. This is the match we've all been awaiting. I can't believe Ric Flair last week challenged Mr. Perfect and put his career on the line.
I got to go to ringside. I got to see Flair.
Yeah, I guess you do. Bobby Heenan headed up to ringside to greet the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
They have a little thing going on the side, do they, Vince?
Well, I'll tell you what, it has been a relationship that took Ric Flair to the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And Flair puts it all on the line, and so does Mr. Perfect here tonight on Monday Night Raw, right here on the USA Network. And you can see by the look of concern on Bobby Heenan's face, this matchup means everything to Ric Flair and to Mr. Perfect. Bobby Heenan joining us again.
Am I on?
You, are you hello, on? Hello. You better hope Ric Flair is on tonight.
He's always on.
Oh, here, look at this. Look at the look of confidence on the face of Mr. Perfect.
You know, I advised Flair not to take this match.
You did not.
Yes, I did. What? Anything can happen on Monday Night Raw. That official can do something to backstab us. A Jack Tunney can do something. I don't like this. I have a financial investment in that man, but you couldn't talk to him. He was so upset at Mr. Perfect, he's risking his career. If he's going to put his career on the line, he must know something. It's bye-bye, Mr. Perfect.
Oh, wait a minute. The same is true of Mr. Perfect. I think this is not a wise decision for either competitor.
No, it's not.
Both competitors, two of the greatest ever in the World Wrestling Federation, and Mr. Perfect putting his career
Bobby
on the
Heenan.
Line. Big kisser.
Yes, yes.
Big smile on his face. He likes what he sees. Oh, come on. Flair attacking. He wants to stop the match by opening that wound.
Doesn't matter.
This
you
man
win.
Will stoop, any... to stoop to any depths to win this match.
That is exactly right.
Rob Bartlett, you haven't said a word. What's going on?
I'm speechless, Vince. I've never seen anything like this in my entire life. These two guys are beating the bejeepers out of each other.
Oh, and another chop.
Wait a minute. Hit him.
Wait a minute.
Look. No. Look at Perfect. He's turned into a punching bag. But what resolve by Mr. Perfect.
He's out on his feet.
Flair's chops don't even mean anything.
He's out on his feet. Ring the bell.
And look at this.
Oh,
yes.
No.
Yes. Talk about momentum. Now, Perfect moving in on Flair, who's backing out. Mr. Perfect with Flair.
What chop.
And all of a sudden, what resilience by Perfect.
Flair for the ride.
Oh, my. About up and down.
Now.
And a close.
Yeah, nailed him. What a right hand. What a right hand.
And Ric Flair now is the one on the canvas. What action in this matchup. Oh, look at that. That's unbelievable.
No.
Idiot.
Oh,
so is that.
Oh, my God, no.
One.
No.
It's over in three,
no.
Yes.
No. Get your
I thought he had him for sure. I thought Perfect had Flair for sure. What excitement in this matchup. This is the kind of athleticism you'd expect in the World Wrestling Federation.
I'm at two and three.
The foot, the foot.
Come on. Look at the foot wrap. Come on. Oh, look at that. And the official.
He can't.
Wait a minute.
That.
A reversal.
No. Yes, 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 yes.
Oh. A kick out
they
by
are
Flair.
Literally, McMahon, fighting for their lives.
Off the rope, puts the brakes.
Perfect clutch, one, two, yes, he got there.
No, no,
he got there.
Oh, my God, no. No, no, no.
Mr. Perfect victorious. Bobby Heenan has thrown Ric Flair's career away.
No, no,
it's
no.
Your fault, Bobby Heenan. Bobby Heenan, besieged by apoplexy. Look at this. He can't believe what has happened. He can't believe that Ric Flair is no longer in the WWF. Mr. Perfect victorious and perhaps his greatest victory to date.
That was an amazing match, Vince.
Bobby Heenan will never forgive himself for allowing Flair to issue the challenge and accept both men, Perfect and Flair, putting their careers on the line. But nonetheless, it's Mr. Perfect now who has chased Ric Flair out of the World Wrestling Federation. What action on Monday Night Raw? What action on USA?
Yeah, Perfect!